Hello dear watch freaks and welcome back to my channel The Uhrenbox aka The Watch Box, and today we're gonna compare this San Martin GMT Vintage against the Pagani GMT. If you guys missed those reviews, I will link it in the description or over here on the top in the next few minutes so you can check them out. And yeah, the Pagani did really, really bad in my review. It's still a very, very cheap GMT watch out there, and there is no other good GMT watches on this price range. But yeah, let's flip the camera and find out which watch is better and where the extra money goes on the San Martin. Alright guys, let's do a quick comparison, the San Martin against the Pagani, and we start from the top and go down the button. On both watches we have a sapphire crystal. The Pagani has also a magnifier, where you can see here for a date window, it's also sapphire crystal. We have a flat piece on the Pagani and on the San Martin a little domed sapphire crystal, which looks in my opinion better, but it's because it's a vintage style GMT, so the vintage watches had all domed glass, a mineral glass or a hardlex, so that's why it's a little bit domed. We have a ceramic inlay on the Pagani design, but just on the black blue version. The blue red and the red black version has stainless steel, so Pagani can't do ceramic inserts with the red color, which is really difficult, so they choose just the black blue. Since I like better materials, I'm going for the black blue version, but if you saw my review on the Pagani, I will not keep this watch anyway. On the San Martin we have a sapphire bezel insert, which is because it's a vintage style watch, so they choose the sapphire crystal to have a scratch resistant bezel, because if you choose a stainless steel, which would have been more vintage, it would scratch very, very fast. So I'm thankful that they gone for the sapphire crystal. Let me zoom a little bit more inside so we have better look at the watches. So the materials used here are very, very good in a high class. Just workmanship on the watches are mostly different. On paper, the Pagani has also 316L stainless steel, but after the stories about the Banyar, which is a Pagani company in the end, I'm really not sure about it. I mean, it's stainless steel, but I don't think it's 316L stainless steel, because the weight of the watches is much different. The San Martin is definitely heavier, it makes more substance to the Pagani. The dimensions are almost same, 40mm cases. The Pagani is 14.5 and the San Martin is on the top 14.1 to operate the bezel much more easier, as you remember from my review. The Pagani has a 60 click bezel insert, which is, yeah, okay, it's not the best. I'm not complaining about 60 clicks. I love 60 clicks, to be honest, because you have 60 seconds, so it makes in my eyes sense to have a 60 click bezel also on the diving watches. I mean, why do you need 120 clicks anyway? You have 120 clicks on the San Martin, and those clicks are very, very nice, you guys know, and it's very, very, yeah, no backplay, nothing. And on the on the Pagani you have a small backplay, but in the end it's yeah, 75 euro to 300 euro watch, so what else you would accept? The loom on the Pagani is the worst you can get. It's really bad. The San Martin has C3 Superluminova, so very, very nice and very well done. You have printed indexes on the San Martin. Everything is printed. On the Pagani, they go for the Rolex style and you have applied indexes. But yeah, without a good loom, it brings just nothing. The loom pip is very, very bad. It's reflecting so much. It's very hard to read the date in the end. And that's what a loom pip should do. It should make it easier to read the date and not make it worse. I don't like it. I like the Batman style over the Pepsi style. That's for sure. And should be told in the end. But I like this vintage style, you guys know, it's really, really fantastic. So on the materials, on top, sapphire crystal both, ceramic to sapphire. It depends, I like ceramic more, but I'm very good with the sapphire crystal. They are both on same level, but the quality of workmanship on the San Martin is definitely better here. So let's move on to the case. The brushing and finishing on the Pagani is okay, considering the price. You have polished side profiles on both sides, so like Rolex GMT has also. The brushing on the top is nothing good in the end. The bracelet integration is very good, it's fine. But you guys remember how hard it was for me to take it out. I even skipped the strap show, which I always do. Really, really bad. But that's another story. The finish, the brushing on the San Martin is next level. And yeah, nothing comparable from China to this company. The brushing is very, very well. The polishing area on the corner here is extremely nice, and the brushing is even with the bracelet. So if you look from here, the brushing on the case and bracelet is the same finish. I don't know if you can see it on the camera, but it's very well done and the integration is perfectly. Just the male end link is a little bit disappointing, but no problem with my 7.5 inch, so for me completely fine. Coming to the bracelets, you guys know San Martin is the bracelet king in my eyes, and it's nothing against the Pagani. I mean, the Pagani design has more flex to it, as more as a banana. Very bad. This bracelet is just, yeah, you guys know, it's just bad. It also came with a scratch, a really bad scratch on the bracelet here, on this link here, as you can see. So I got €14 partial refund from AliExpress for this issue with my bracelet. Very, very bad. This decision from AliExpress and the bad communication from the seller is really disgusting me. And after all the story about Benya, you guys know in my review from Pagani, I told you I'm really done with this company and I will not buy any watches of Pagani anymore. Just was just the order before the story of Benya came out. If it would be earlier, I would skip it and I would buy a GMT from Mambushi or Leash, even Leash, yeah. Sorry, but Pagani is done for me. The bracelet is, like I said, the worst on this one. And on the bracelet from San Martin, you see no, almost no play, yeah. Really, really nice. The clasp is milled. You have 4 micro adjustments, very nice. Engraved. On the Pagani, you have this Rolex style clasp. It's not bad. I do love it in the end, but it's again very bad executed from Pagani and it has so much play here. I don't know how long this bracelet will hold anyway. You have 2 more micro adjustments inside there in the glass, as you can see, but you need to extend this diving extension here. Yeah, I don't know why it has a diving extension with 100 meters, but okay. And then you can adjust it with 2 more micros. It's okay, but I prefer the St. Martin with the 4 micro adjustments where you can adjust it very fast. I hope to see this year much easier, like a glide lock system from St. Martin. That would be really awesome. I think they can do it, and I hope they will do it this year. What else? The case bags. Yeah, on the Pagani you have an exhibition case bag, which shows you this, yeah, cheap movement. It's not a good movement, but if it's your first mechanical watch, it would look nice. Also here they go for the Rolex style with red plate there. I don't know, I don't like it. It's very well engraved, and also try to decorate it very nice. For 75 euros, very respectable in the end. On a St. Martin 300 euro watch, you get a blank case back. The finish, the workmanship is outstanding. It's very solid and very well made. But come on, St. Martin, 300 euro, no engravings, nothing, no logo, nothing there. Please, please change this fact and please do something there. Because if I pay 300 euros almost, I want to see a little bit of decorations in the end on my watch. So the movement inside, it's a high beat on the St. Martin. You have 28,800 beats per hour, 8 ticks per second. And on the Pagani, you have a low beat with 21,600 beats per hour and 6 ticks per second. It's a proper GMT in the end, but on the St. Martin, the hand winding is extremely nice, very solid, and if you want to operate the GMT hand, is very, very nice. It springs, it jumps from hour to hour, and you can hear that click and you can feel it. Very, very nice. On the Pagani, in the other hand, and the screwing is on the St. Martin. Very, very nice, well done. Very safely on the Pagani, also screw down, but the GMT hand, it doesn't jumps from hour to hour, so it's, yeah, you can move it all the way up, and if you want to put it there, it jumps itself on the right position, as you can see. It's okay, it's 75 euros in the end. The screwing is, yeah, not always good. I think you can lubricate it a little bit with oil or something like that. It's fine. In the end, it's 75 euros. I need to say it every time, because the St. Martin costs 4 times more. But I don't had any news or informations about that St. Martin had lied about anything. Pagani did with the Banyar, and I think they lied with a few other things too. That's why I say spend a few bucks more, save your money 2 or 3 months, and go for a really better watch. You can go also for the Chronos, but you guys know I'm not so keen with the Chronos. In the end, also they have managed to put a magnifier, which is just a hard lens, on a 300 euro watch. Oh, really, Chronos? I would buy a stain if I had bought the Chronos with a magnifier, which is Hartlex. I mean, it's the first thing you hit anywhere because it's outstanding. And then it's a Hartlex. Sorry. How could you? The Pagani, in the end, has sapphire magnifier without any coating, so it's really, really bad. But that's another story which I told already. Like I said, if you have the money, go for a St. Martin or even a Chronos, it's the better options. And if you really need a cheaper GMT one, and the name is not so bad for you. Go for a Mambushi. Those watches were really, really good. And I think the GMTs will be the same level. If the name is not disturbing you, go for a Mambushi or a Leash. But Leash, I'm also not so keen because they're lying with their informations on AliExpress, having Sapphire Crystal, having NH35 on their Sapomars, but it's not. You can see it on the pictures. That's not an NH35. So again, it's I thought those new companies like Steel Dive, San Martin, and everything, they don't lie. They are very good companies. And now starting again with those lying things, it's like going 10 years back on all this fake and scam things like before from China. That's very, very bad, and very, very bad reputations also to other companies. They don't hurt themselves, they're also hurting the other names, other companies from China. That's very, very bad. So Pagani, this was my last watch from you guys, and I will sell this immediately. I'm sad that two more Banyars are on the way, but yeah, maybe I do the same like Watch Me With Watches and just smash them. Stay healthy, guys, and take care. Bye bye.